Today is 10 days, which are 1 week and 3 days of the Omer. We are now in the week of Givurah, of discipline, and for this 10th day, we explore the emotional attribute of Tiferet, the Tiferet of Givurah, finding compassion in the way we discipline. So Tiferet is compassion, Givurah is discipline. As we discussed yesterday in the Chesed of Givurah, Chesed was loving kindness, we need to have love in our ways of discipline. So sometimes the way that we actually show our love is to discipline, for example, with our children. It's difficult at times, but it's a necessary component for them to grow up safe and secure. What we learned today is that not only should love be the driving factor within our discipline, but also compassion first. And we need to start with ourselves. It's said that self-discipline begins with the mastery of our thoughts. If we don't control what we think, then we cannot control what we do. So mindfulness is everything, knowing where we're coming from, knowing where we want to go, being centered and mindful in what we want to achieve and accomplish with both our love and our discipline. Buddha said, to enjoy good health, to bring true happiness to one's family, to bring peace to all, one must first discipline and control one's own mind. If a man can control his mind, he can find the way to enlightenment, and all wisdom and virtue will naturally come to him. So we need to take a look at ourselves. We need to examine our motivations. All humankind, man and woman alike, needs to do this. And this is what we're doing with this Omer process. We are delving inward to our innermost being to examine, to uncover, to learn, to grow, and to expand our awareness that we accomplish and receive out into the world, into our interactions and our relationships with others. And everything will benefit. We will all be nourished and uplifted. So now as we move to Tiferet in Givurah, finding compassion in our discipline, we must monitor our level of compassion. When our love from another and for another has a compassionate exchange, we are giving unconditional acceptance. We are loving with our eyes and our heart open wide to the other person's specific needs. We are giving them what they need. We are taking into consideration their point of view, their perspective, and their emotional capabilities and their ability that they have to actually receive our love. We are loving them with all of our being for love's own sake, not with an eye toward what we might gain, but with a vision, the vision necessary to be truly considerate of them. The ability to love and to feel is the greatest gift that has been given to us by God. We are on the 10th day. The number 10 is the number for God, for divinity. We have godliness inside of us. And we are meant to reflect this divinity and this light in everything that we do. We have been given the extraordinary opportunity and the capacity to give and receive love. We can feel and experience life at a very intimate level with those that we love. And we can do this only in the earth plane. And we do this in relationship. When we choose to see others' needs and relate to them with compassion, we are coming from a pure state of love for love's own sake. We are giving unconditionally, selflessly, with a full and complete and open heart, body, and mind. We are created in the image of God. We have been created to be co-partners and a reflection of the divine light in this physical world. We are meant to restore and balance the repair that is necessary of our shattered vessels. So all of the world, we were shattered vessels at the beginning of time, of creation, and now we have to, in a sense, put Humpty Dumpty back together again. And we do this by co-partnering with God and in the world that we create with one another. When we love and we share and we examine ourselves, when we look at our emotional attributes and things that need to be rectified and elevated, and we do this, we begin to put ourselves back together, make ourselves whole, and in so doing, our world as well. Tom Elho said, when we feel the clown, when we have been played, if we have lived by heart, acted out of compassion, we are the substance of the play rather than merely being played. No one ever wants to feel like they've been played. And everyone wants to feel like they have value and they have worth and they want to be treated as such. When we apply compassionate discipline with our actions, we raise the bar on all of our interpersonal relations and our interactions. The world as we know it changes because we are truly loving and caring for our neighbor and our loved ones with the compassion and the understanding to truly make a difference. We affect real change. We affect real growth. The Dalai Lama said, love and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. Without them, humanity cannot survive. We need one another. We need to love and we need to be loved. And we need to do this with compassion, disciplining ourselves and the way that we give, being mindful of our interactions, thereby elevating all. So think about when you're compassionate, when maybe you've acted with not a compassionate sense of mindfulness, when you have reached out to somebody when you didn't really feel like it, but you gave to them something that they needed. You were empathetic, you looked to them, and you realized that there was something that you might be able to share that might help them. And think about maybe somebody that you've neglected that you might want to reach out to with a phone call or, you know, with, you know, kindness, and lift them up with compassion, lift them up with discipline in your own actions and with the compassionate love that you have within you. And everyone will be elevated and enriched by your light, the light that comes from your soul and also the divine. And that is day 10 of the Omer.